Hi, my name is Joel Scott, and I am a NASA scientist in the Earth Science Division. Specifically, I study ocean biology and biogeochemistry. Now, that includes the living things that are in our ocean, like phytoplankton and zooplankton, which fish eat. We also study the properties of the ocean that impact biology, like what kind of nutrients are present and how carbon cycles. Did you know that roughly every second breath you take comes from phytoplankton in the ocean? Now, phytoplankton are microscopic, single-cell creatures in the upper ocean. They have chlorophyll, the same stuff that makes plants green, and they use photosynthesis just like plants on land to convert carbon dioxide in the ocean to make food for themselves and release oxygen, some of which goes back to the atmosphere for us to breathe. But not all phytoplankton are good for the environment. Have you heard of red tide, maybe along the Florida coast? Or have you seen green slop floating in a river or a lake? It looks like this. Here's a picture of a boat moving through an algal bloom in Lake Erie. Now, this doesn't just look gross. I mean, who wants to swim in green water? It has real health impacts. Here's another picture from Lake Erie, and that structure sticking up out of the water is the city of Toledo, Ohio's water intake. And these harmful algal blooms can actually make the water toxic to drink and starve a whole city of safe, drinkable water. So these blooms can be a real problem for humans, since we need lakes and rivers and water for drinking and recreation, fishing, and so much more. To help identify bad phytoplankton blooms, the ones that harm humans or the aquatic ecosystem, scientists and water resource managers have developed water quality indicators based on satellite data from NASA and from other space agencies around the globe, including Europe and Japan. Satellites in orbit around the Earth pass overhead and they see bodies of water. These satellites take measurements of how much blue versus how much green or red light is being reflected back. This is very similar to how our eyes work when we can see bright blue water on a tropical beach or when we see green water in a slow-moving river. Our eyes see the color of the water and we immediately recognize what is in the water. So thinking about our satellites measuring the color of water, scientists have developed a water quality index to tell us how much phytoplankton or how much other stuff is in the water, like suspended sediments or dissolved leaves. Satellite data tells us so much about our planet and the environment. Satellites like NASA's MODIS, or the upcoming ocean color satellite PACE, see the entire planet every couple days. Other satellites like Landsat or Sentinel provide data at higher spatial resolution, but not as often. Still, this is far more efficient than sending a person out every day to make sure that the water is healthy and safe to play in or to drink. Water quality can change at a moment's notice, and satellites can quickly tell us if there's a problem. A strong wind can come along and stir up sediments within a lake or coastal area, or runoff caused by rain can carry fertilizer, nitrogen, phosphorus, iron, from farms into rivers which flow out to estuaries into the coast and can trigger an algal bloom. We as humans are part of this planet and its ecosystems, and our activity can impact the environment around us. So our challenge to you is to help better understand the changes in our interconnected Earth system as seen through the Earth Observing Dashboard. During the pandemic, our behavior worldwide was changed because of the imposed lockdowns. How could these changes in our behavior have impacted water quality? We're challenging you to develop visualizations that connect the water quality data from the dashboard with other in-situ and satellite data, such as wind speed, precipitation, river discharge, and more, to help us understand how water quality is interconnected with other Earth parameters. Try making an animation or a visualization of how these data changed over time and changed during the pandemic. This can help us understand how water quality and environmental conditions were affected by the pandemic when a lot of us were stuck at home and human activity was limited. And once you have some animations and visualizations of satellite data made, like wind, precipitation, or river discharge, try correlating them with the water quality index. Try designing a tool to see if these different data can vary together or are related to each other within the dashboard. Try doing it with or without lag or lead times and see what you find. Seeing how different types of data are related to each other and co-vary is one of the ways we do science at NASA and is how we better understand our planet and its ecosystems. Are you up for the challenge?